Hi, I'm George Pearson. In this Photoshop Elements video, I'll show you a fast way to add some light rays into a picture, just like that. Now, if you enjoy this video, make sure you click that like button and also share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. And if you want to learn a lot more about Photoshop Elements, take a look at my complete training and you'll find links for that up in the cards and also down in the description. Okay, let's get to it. For this fast technique, I'm starting off with a picture that already has some light in it, just no light rays. Let me take a look at that one. It's right over here. There we go. So there's already some light in here. There's a window, so you can imagine there being light rays. We'll start with this. Let me just close down that file. There we go. The first thing I want to do, though, is to clean this up. I want to get rid of this bit of graffiti over there on the right side wall. Really easy to do. Let's just zoom in here. I'll stay out pretty far on this. And then we'll use the clone stamp tool. And a good size stamp, I have 125 pixels right now. I'm just gonna grab some stuff up here, hold the Alt key down and click, then just bring that down. Let's just copy some of that right over into here. And just quickly clean that out. There we go, pretty good. All right, so that's taken care of. Let's now go back onto fit on screen. Now for the light rays, we need to have this image darker than it currently is. It needs to be a little bit on the dark side so that the rays actually lighten things up. Let me just show you the basic concept on this lightening up, and that is that we'll take an area. Let me just make a new layer up here. There we are. And let's make an area in here. Let's grab the rectangular tool. Let's put a rectangle right on top of that. Let's fill this with white. Just grab the paint bucket. Fill it with white. We can then deselect that. That's fine. Deselect. Now what we need to do is just to blend this white into the background using our blend modes. The one I like is soft light for this. You can see what it does. It actually lightens up the image underneath of that white rectangle. So there is without and there it is with. That's the basic concept here, is just using a layer with white on it to lighten up part of the picture. Okay, let's go ahead now and make our adjustments. First, come down to the background layer here and go up to Layer, Adjustment Layer, and Levels. No need to clip this to that layer, just choose OK. We'll use this just to darken the image down a little bit. Now, the main control here for that is this middle control. This is kind of the main tones. Going to the left lightens it up, going to the right darkens it down, as you can see there. I'll just come back here, oh, to about 70, 71, 72, in here someplace. Let's just type this in at 72. That looked pretty good. So that darkens down the overall picture. I can show and hide that right here. There it is. Reason for it being darker is that it just allows the light rays to show up better with it being darker. I'll also bring down the whites a little bit in the picture. And I don't want to bring them down this way. This actually lightens them up. See that? So you need to bring the whites down a little bit. You can do that down here in the output levels. Here's our whites in the output. If I pull this in, it darkens down the whites a little bit right there. So let's set this one at 221 on this. Just kind of darkens down that. So we have a nice, just a bit of a darker picture in there so the light rays will show up better. Okay, so there's our basic adjustment. So the top level, 0.72 for the middle, and the bottom one, 221 on the right-hand side. That's all you have to do there. Let's now put in our white. Now for the white, I want it to be real bright over here and fading out down over here. So it needs to be fading this direction. I just want it to be a bit directional, and we'll do that by using a layer and then putting white in here as a gradient. Let me just show you this on this layer as an example. First, I'll grab my gradient, bring up the gradients in here. The default is foreground to background. The second one is foreground to clear. I have my foreground set to white, so that gives me white to clear. So you want to have that set up. And then if you use the radial control over here, and if I click upper right hand corner and pull down to the bottom left hand corner, it gives me bright white up here and going less and less light as it moves over to the left hand side. So that's the basic idea behind this. Okay, let's go ahead and just delete that layer. We'll be doing this with gradient layers. So layer, fill layer, and gradient. The reason I'm using a gradient layer is it allows me to make adjustments later on if I want to. It just makes it real easy for adjustments. Now this comes in, as you can see here, with an automatic gradient. So first thing you want to do is you want to change this to radial, like that. And then grab this, actually pull that radial up here, upper right hand corner. You can put it right there, kind of upper corner of where the window is. There we go. So you can pull that up, and then you can increase the scale of the gradient right over here. So set the gradient at 300%. And that just about matches what we did with our example, except I moved the hotspot over the window, right, up right-hand corner of the window itself. Everything else you can leave the same, choose OK. So there's the basic hot gradient. Now I want it to be just inside of the window and not everywhere else. So I'll do that with the layer mask. One of the nice things about bringing this in as an adjustment layer is it automatically gives us that layer mask. So over to the Polygonal Lasso tool. I have the settings at new and feathering set at 0. And come right down here, bottom right corner of the window, click there, pull just outside. Now the top of the window is out here someplace, then another corner is right over there. So I'll come outside, click on that, and I'll come down to that corner. And then pull it down above the chair. So up here someplace, you can kind of see where the light part is, the window in there. See, there's this kind of light right in here. Right to the corner of the light there, I'll come down to the corner of the light down here, and then bring it around the bottom like that, and then back up to that part of the window. Now that selects this inside section. What I want is the outside part selected, so let's invert this, select and inverse. So the outside is now selected. Grab the color, make sure the color is now on black. There you go. Paint bucket, and just click outside. That fills in that outside with black. So there's our light streak. Let's now deselect that. Now obviously it's too hard on the edges in here. This is okay down there, but the edges are too hard here and here. Let's soften that up by putting a Gaussian blur on the layer mask itself. So filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And if you look at the edges in here, you can adjust how much blur you want. I'm going to bring this one up to about, oh, maybe 15 or 20. Let's just try 20. Maybe a little bit too soft. Let's try 15. This is kind of a personal choice in here and how much you want to have that edge. I think 15 on this one. We'll make it a little bit tighter on our later ones. There's our little 15 softness on the edge. Choose OK. Blurs that out. Now, still too bright. Looks fake. You want to blend this into the image. So we'll do the same thing we did down here with my example. We'll set the blend mode to soft light, and that blends that right into the image. Kind of hard to see here. If I show and hide that, you can actually see where that is though. So it actually is lightening up that bit of the image. Okay, now I want to have another one inside of this. So take this layer, drag it up to the new layer button. Kind of brightens that up again, so it is darker and brighter. But I want it brighter in the middle part of this. So let's change the layer mask. I'll grab the Polygonal Lasso tool again, and I'll come just inside, maybe about where that corner is, right there, corner of the window, you can kind of see that. Click there, pull down to the top of the chair, and then just out and around a little bit, down to the bottom of the chair, and then back over here, kind of, oh, maybe right in here somewhere, and clear to the edge of the window again, and follow that edge around, and then back to the beginning. So just kind of inside the other one. Again, I need to have this outside selected and not the inside selected. Let's go up to select, inverse, back to the paint bucket. Make sure you're on black. Then click outside here. There we go. May take a couple of clicks because we have a little bit of an edge happening in there. Now don't worry about that little bit here. So click right in against this selection. If it kind of misses, that's fine. It's perfect. I actually kind of like those little streaks happening in there. Okay, and then just deselect. Now the edge is still too hard in here, so let's soften this layer mask down. Back up to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And I'm going to set the radius now at 5, so it's a tighter radius. You can see the streaks happening in here now. Looks pretty good. You can go maybe a little more. Let's try 10. I think that looks better. Choose OK. Okay, there's the second one of our layers. Let's now copy this again. There we go. Same exact trick on this one. I'll come in with the polygonal lasso tool. I'll come in a lot tighter this time, just kind of in here someplace. And this come down to just the chair back. And I'll just follow around kind of where the chair back is, like that. And then back out again out to the frame of the window. There we go. So here's our inside section. Same thing, I want to have this light and dark outside, so let's invert, select inverse. We're still on black, back to the paint bucket, and then click right in right next to that selection, just like that. If it leaves some streaks, that's perfect, leave that those alone. And then select, deselect. Once again, let's do a Gaussian blur on this. So filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's try 5 this time. It's a little bit smaller. Maybe it's a little too sharp. Maybe let's try 7, kind of halfway between that and 10. That looks pretty good. Choose OK. And there we go. There's your light rays streaking in through the window. Now to see this, how much this is working out for us, let's take the background layer. I'll make a copy of that layer. Pull that up on top. So there is the original. Of course, we have the side fixed over here. No graffiti, but that's the original. And there it is with our adjustment, with our light streak. So like our original and light streak adjustment. Again, fast technique, but I think it does a real nice, effective job on there. So there you go. That's how to do a quick light raise coming in through a window. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.